Welcome to the Monday, April 23rd, 2012 edition of Erneberry's Daily Video, sponsored by Erneberry's 2012 Executive Conference. In today's report, we review our HRI Movers of the Week report, and later, a report on the unsettled European egg market. Now let's look at the markets with your host, Jamie Chadwick.
Earth Day was celebrated over the weekend, with April 22nd serving as the official day of observation. U.S. pork producers announced their continued efforts of providing Americans with a safe, wholesome, and environmentally friendly food supply with their We Care initiative. National Pork Board President Everett Faulkner said Earth Day is an annual event which is celebrated around the globe, but for pork producers, every day is Earth Day. The initiative spells out the principles that U.S. pork producers have committed to, including producing safe food, protecting and promoting animal well-being, and ensuring practices to public health, among others. For more information on Pork Industries' We Care initiative and for other stories in the food service industry, please visit foodmarket.com. Now, red meat market reporter Russell Barton takes a look at Erneberry's HRI Buyer's Guide, which is a weekly publication dedicated to current commodity prices being paid to wholesalers and purveyors by hotels, restaurants, and institutions for the week of April 17th through April 23rd.
Our biggest gains this week stem from the box beef complex. The gooseneck, or bottom round, has seen renewed interest develop from both domestic and international markets. Retail features in combination with the product, recently seen as undervalued, brought buyers back into the market. In the pork market, after falling substantially in the first quarter, trimmings finally seem to have cleaned up supply lines and have appreciated as a result. Ground pork typically sees an increase in interest as grilling season gets underway, and this 4.17% increase may be the sign of upcoming improvement in what has been a fairly beat-up market. Moving over to the poultry market, roaster chicken values have declined over the last week or so as promotional activity has waned. This has resulted in added availabilities and ensuing discounted offerings. Finally, the shell egg market continues post-Easter adjustments this past week. Subpar retail demand has been reported in all areas, leaving supplies of large available. Buying interest is minimal as most have plenty to fill their orders, leaving sellers forced to discount their offerings. Our quotations in the large category have declined 12.61% as a result and may continue to come under some pressure in the short term.
Thanks, Russ. To wrap up today's video, egg market reporter Brian Moscageri analyzes an unsettled European egg market and its impact on prices.
The European situation continues to be a fairly unsettled one as consumer demand since the holiday is down significantly. Most state that supplies are somewhat tight, but more than sufficiently meet lagging interest. Prices of breaking eggs have declined as a result, which isn't all that unusual during this time of year. Our quotations are down 4.2% this week, but remain 40% over the three-year average at this time. Some feel that price declines may only be temporary as remaining cage modifications loom before the July 31st deadline. We would think that these price declines would reduce interest in U.S. imports, but sellers of finished product in the EU are holding their asking prices with the expectation that raw costs will rebound. Dried yolk seems to be the item most likely to move across the Atlantic, with prices in the EU more than double that here in the States.
Thanks, Brian. That concludes today's video. Thanks for watching and see you next time.
This broadcast is sponsored by Erneberry's 2012 Executive Conference Strategies for the Future, April 29th through May 1st at Caesars Palace in Las Vegas, Nevada. Visit erneberry.com/executive for more information or give us a call at 732-240-5330 to register today.